Welcome again, everyone. So today I'm going to talk about your dream. What are these dream programs? What are their evaluation criteria and how you can get into one of these programs? So if you are on your USMLE journey, you have doubtlessly heard the terms program X is an IMG friendly program. Program Y is an IMG friendly program and I don't stand a chance. So we'll talk about the perceptions and myths around this IMG friendly programs, which are dream programs for many IMGs. We will also talk about how you can improve your profile, your CV to get a shot at these programs. We'll talk about your dream program. Is it the Hopkins, the Mayo, Stanford, Tufts University, Cincinnati Children, or one of the several others? Let me tell you, it may be hard, but it's possible. Like I said, many of our students make the cut every year. So can you. So we'll talk about what it takes to match at one of these places. There's also a blog on our website, which you can refer to for more details. Now, before I go over the top 10 criteria, it may come as a surprise to some of you that the top programs evaluate the IMGs similarly. So when you hear the term, the program is not quote unquote IMG friendly, in most cases, it means that IMGs that apply are not competitive enough, whether it is their scores, electives, quality of LORs, or other factors. The idea is not to discuss if these criteria are fair or not to the IMGs, but to give you an overview so that you can decide and give it your best shot. Also, you may ask, what if I don't meet all the criteria? Does it mean I cannot match at these places? The answer is, there is no perfect applicant, even in IMGs. So try to do the best and see which of these criteria you can improve on. The more boxes you check, the better chances you will have. Another thing to note is the fact that if you're just starting your USMLE journey, you may have more control over some of these factors and can customize your profile for a better shot. Alright, so what are these criteria? First, the scores, and that should be a no-brainer. Even the IMGs that match our top programs have very high scores. I regularly discuss with IMGs, and it is hard for them to match at these programs without high scores. Of course, the scores requirement varies across specialties. So internal medicine in general will have higher score requirement than say pathology nowadays. When I say high scores, it is within that specialty of interest. Second are the electives. You absolutely must try for electives. If you are still in medical school and if you can do these, go for them. Electives in the specialty make your CV very strong, along with, of course, the recommendation letters that I'll talk about. For IMGs, just as for IMGs, quality of electives or clerkship matters. So if you have electives at, say, Harvard or any good university, you will definitely have a leg up. In fact, we have several videos in which we talk about how to do well in your rotations, including electives, and also the process to apply for electives at top programs. Third is the year of graduation. Again, like the IMGs who overwhelmingly are recent graduates, if you are an IMG who's a recent graduate, it'll be a big plus for you overall. But specifically when it comes to the top university programs. Top tier programs in most specialties prefer applicants who are current with their clinical knowledge and they think they are more teachable. Fourth Fourth is the letter of recommendations. This is perhaps the most overlooked part of an IMG profile and something many applicants ignore. You may be aware that many attending use templatized LORs for IMGs. Or worse, some applicants are asked to write their own LORs, which the physician will just sign off on. A top-tier program expects very specific, customized, and a detailed. Fifth is research. Doing research in big institutes may help you get a call from top programs. Harvard, Mayo, Cleveland Clinic, Stanford, again, are some of those places where IMGs do a research stint, and it helps them a lot. In fact, a couple of years ago, one of our students did a research elective at NIH, one of the premier research organizations in the US, and the student matched at Cincinnati Children's, one of the top IMG programs for pediatrics. While doing your research, you will be able to meet new folks. Some of them may know a person who's related to the residency selection process or so on, or they could help you in some way. At the same time, you're showing your commitment, perhaps social skills, and willingness to be part of a team. The sixth point relates to research, and it is having publications in international journals with high impact factor. This includes, but is not limited to, JAMA, Nature, and so on. Whether you have worked in institutes in the US to have these publications, or you were involved in an international research that was eventually published in these journals, having such accomplishment is a big deal and a great addition to your application. The seventh is a slightly tricky point, which is MPH and or a PhD. Having a master's degree, especially if you do it in the US, can be a big plus for some university programs. You may do masters in biostatistics, epidemiology, and many others. Of course, it could be costly and lengthy, could take a year or two, but may be worth it. Now, a word of caution. PhD from a US college may be quite helpful in, say, pathology, but in many other fields like internal medicine, it may not be that useful to just because it takes a long time. You are away from the clinical practice. Eighth point is a preliminary or the transitional year. Sometimes doing a preliminary year in some high-tier residency program may be your winning ticket to enter that program in the categorical specialty. You may match in the same program or apply to and get interviewed by another amazing program, since now you will have 1 year of fully accredited USCE at a top program, in addition to, of course, the knowledge you gain. Ninth is professional contact. It is amazing how social life can shape you. Importance of having contacts or making new ones during your research, MPH, or the USCE cannot be overemphasized. Programs always prefer a person who they already know and whom they are sure they can work with. Consider attending conferences in your field as well. Finally, the 10th point is your exceptional academic record. Famous institutes like applicants who are bright, smart, and committed. An excellent academic record in your med school always will help to prove this. So if you are from your country's top medical colleges, for example, and have a stellar academic record, like a gold medalist, it'll definitely help. Now, I have another point, you know, over and above this 10, which is luck. Of course, you may have heard being at the right time at the right place, and that may be something you need, and that could help you. Occasionally, luck could, of course, play a role. Be outgoing, interact nicely with as many people as you can, and who knows, your luck may turn. So we have personally helped many IMGs get into these dream programs. Believe me, it can be done. But it does need a lot of planning, hard work, focus, and initiative. Remember, the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. If you can dream it, you can do it. So start now, and good luck to all of you.